Subtract the fractions, 4/5 minus 1/2. Let me draw a physical model here. Something like that. And then, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is 5/5, or 1. Now, 4/5 is 1, 2, 3, 4. Now we're going to take away 1/2. Now 1/2 would be 1/2 right here. Now that would be about right there. So we would take that away, but then there would be this amount and then plus this amount left over, this whole thing. And we don't really know how much that is. So what we need to do is create a common division or common denominator so that we know exactly what we have left over. So if we have 1/5 and 1/2, the common denominator is going to be 5 times 2, which is 10. So we need to take this 4/5 and divide it into tenths. So I'm going to use this new one that I drew down here, divide it into tenths. Okay, now if we're going to make this equivalent, there were 4 of these, so they're going to be 8 of these. So there's the 8/10. Now we have 8/10, and we're going to take away 1/2. Now if we have 10/10 as the whole unit, we're going to take away half of those. That would be 5/10 we take away. So we take away 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, leaving 1, 2, 3/10. Okay, so our answer is going to be 3/10. Now to work with the fractions up here, to get the common denominator, it's 4/5 times 2 over 2, which is 8/10. And then for the 1/2, it's going to be 1/2 times 5 over 5 equals 5/10. And then we're going to have 8/10 minus 5/10, which is 3/10. So you can say either way, you get the exact same answer, 3/10.